Jai Om Vishnupad Paramahans Parukaracharya Astorasar Shishimati Bhakti Vedan Swami Jagat Guru Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai ISKCON Founder Acharya Jagat Guru Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai Om Vishnupad Paramahansa Parukaracharya Astorasar Shishimati Bhakti Siddhan Goswami Maharaj Ki Namacharya Shri Haridas Thakur Ki All glories to the assembled devotees. All glories to the assembled devotees. All glories to the assembled devotees. All glories to Shishi Guru and Gauranga. So we are reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 3, Chapter 3, entitled The Lord's Pastimes Out of Vrindavan. And today's shloka is number 22. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Narayanam Namaskritya. Naram Chaiva Narottama. Devim Saraswati Vyasa Tato Jaya Mudirae. Before reciting the Srimad Bhagavatam, which is the very means of conquest, one should offer respectful obeisances unto the personality of Godhead, Narayan, unto Narayan Rishi, the supermost human being, and unto Mother Saraswati, the goddess of learning, and unto Srila Vyasadeva, the author. Naspraesu Abhadresu Nityam Bhagavat Sevaya Bhagavate Uttam Shloke Bhaktir Bhavati Nashtaki. By regular attendance in classes on the Bhagavatam and by rendering of service to the pure devotees, all that is troublesome to the heart is almost completely destroyed. And loving service to the personality of Godhead, who is praised with transcendental songs, is established as an irrevocable fact. Tasya eva ramamanasya samvatsara ganan bahun griyamedesu yogesu viraga samajayata. Tasya eva ramamanasya Samvatsara ganan bahun griyamadesu yogesu viraga samajayata. Tasvaivam ramamanasya samvatsara ganan bahun griyamadesu yogesu viraga samajayata. Tasyaivam ramamanasya samvatsara ganan bahun griyamadesu yogesu viraga samajayata. Please recite. Tasyaivam ramamanasya. Samajayata. Jayata. Tasyaiva mahasya. Tasvema Jai Matajis? Samvatsara Gananbam. Amatesu Yogesu. Jayata. Tasvayama Ramamanasyam. Sara Ganan Bahun. Amatesu Yogesu. Word to word meaning? Tasya, his, evam, thus, ramamanasya, enjoin, samvatsara, years, ganan, many, bahu, great many, grihamedesu, in household life, yogesu, in sex life, viraga, detachment. Samajayata, awakened. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Jagadguru Srila Prabhupada ki jai. The Lord was thus engaged in household life for many, many years, but at last His detachment from ephemeral sex life was fully manifested. Please repeat. The Lord was thus engaged in household life for many, many years, but at last His detachment from ephemeral sex was fully manifested. Purport. Even though the Lord is never attached to any kind of material sex life, as the universal teacher, He remained a householder for many, many years just to teach others how one should live in householder life. Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur explains that the word samajayata means fully exhibited. In all His activities while present on the earth, the Lord exhibited detachment. This was fully displayed when He wanted to teach by example that one should not remain attached to household life for all the days of one's life. One should naturally develop detachment as a matter of course. The Lord's detachment from household life does not indicate detachment from His eternal associates, the transcendental cowherd damsels, but the Lord desired to end His so-called attachment to the three modes of material nature. He can never be detached from the service of His transcendental associates like Rukmini and other goddesses of fortune. As described in the Brahma Samhita 5.29, Lakshmi Sahasra Satta Sambara Sevyamanam. Mom Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale Shrimati Gopal Krishna Goswami Tinamine Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale Shrimati Bhakti Vedanta Swami Tinamine Namaste Saraswati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvisesa Sunyavadi Pastata Dasatarine Om Agyanam Timirandasya Gyananjana Salakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasme Shri Gurve Namah. I was born in the darkest ignorance, and my spiritual master opened my eyes with the torchlight of knowledge. I offer my respectful obeisances unto Him. Krishna Swadamo Bhakade Dharma Gyanadabhi Saha Kalau Nasta Drisham Esa Puranar Anodono Dinda. This Bhagavad Puran is as brilliant as the sun, and it has just arisen after the departure of Lord Krishna to His own abode. Accompanied by religion, knowledge, etc., persons who have lost their vision due to the dense darkness of ignorance in the age of Kali shall get light from this Bhagavad Purana. So I was looking up the meaning of ephemeral. What does that mean in the dictionary? The ephemeral. Ephemeral. Yes. Because short-lived, yes. So it was lasting a short time. That's what the description was. So... Because the purport says the Lord was thus engaged in household life for many, many years, but at last His detachment from ephemeral sex life was fully manifested, which means it was very short-lived. So, in the Bhagavad Gita, we know, Yat karosi yat asnasi yat johosi dadasi yat yat tapasi kantya tat kurushma mat arpanam. That whatever you do, whatever you eat, whatever you offer or give away, and whatever austerities you perform, do that, O son of Kunti, as an offering to me, Krishna instructs Arjuna. So, we have to first distinguish between a Grihastha and a Grihamedhi. These are two important aspects that are mentioned in our Shastras, that and Prabhupada also, Srila Prabhupada also constantly mentions this in his purpose, that we have to be a Grihastha and not a Grihamedhi. And what is the difference between the two? So the purport obviously mentions detachment. One of the main points today is to be detached, eventually to be detached. And then in the purport, Srila Prabhupada specifically mentions that detachment from what? Detachment from household life. So there is detachment from household life. Now Srila Prabhupada in his purport says a man is blessed if he has three things: a good wife, wealth, and good children. These are the three important things Srila Prabhupada mentions, that one is blessed if he has a good wife, good children, and wealth. And then Srila Prabhupada goes further to say that out of the three, the most important is a good wife. However, in his purports, Srila Prabhupada also cautions us, if a man is too attached to a womanly bodily platform, in the next life he will get a woman's body. And likewise, if a woman is too attached to a man's body, the chances of her getting a man's body is more likely. So very important point Srila Prabhupada is stressing here. That for a person in a human form of life who has a masculine body has to be very careful, because he can downgrade himself to a woman's body because of constant consciousness. And Srila Prabhupada actually mentions, actually this is nothing from me, this is what Srila Prabhupada Jagadguru is saying, that Maya's representation in this material world is a woman's body. So that's why this Grihamedhi and Grihastha is very specific, and Lord Krishna is showing us by his own examples. He did not have one wife, he had 16,108 wives. And he was at the same time in each and every palace, as Narad Muni himself witnessed. But the Lord was detached, Vairagya. So he's showing us that even in the midst of all this, how to attain detachment. So, and then in the purport, it's mentioned that Lord wanted to end his so-called attachment to the three modes of material nature. And we know in Bhagavad Gita 7:14, Lord Krishna says, Devi hi esha gunamai mama maya duratyaya mam evaya prabhantyante mayam etam tarantite. So this divine energy of mine, so the Lord starts with that, this is divine energy. Devi hi esha gunamai. We know it is material energy, but it is divine. For us to surpass it is not that easy. Consisting of the three modes of material nature is difficult to overcome, but those who have surrendered unto me can easily cross beyond it. So, in the seventh canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, we have a chapter entitled Instructions for Civilized Man, where we get some very important instructions on how a civilized human being should actually conduct himself, not just in household life, but in this material world. And I wanted to share some of the comments that Srila Prabhupada writes in his purports. And as we know that in the seventh canto, under the instructions for civilized man, it is Narad Muni again instructing who? Yudhishthira Maharaj. And Yudhishthira Maharaj is not an ordinary human being. He is actually the incarnation of Dharmaraj. So he is actually Dharma personified. And we know that Narad Muni is, if you look at it, is literally our Siksha Guru in so many ways, because he's given instructions to Vyasdev. He's given instructions to Dhruva Maharaj. He's given instructions to Yudhishthira Maharaj. So many places. In fact, even when Hiranyakashipu had Hiranyakashipu's wife was being taken away by the demigods, it was again Narad Muni who intervened. So we see Narad Muni is a very important personality in our sampradaya. But in which way? In the way of giving guidance. So during this important discussion between Narad Muni and Yudhishthira Maharaj, what does Narad Muni instruct? He says that by associating with devotees and chanting the Hare Krishna mantra, any man in any condition of life can achieve the highest perfection of life without a doubt. These are Srila Prabhupada's words. So a very sublime, very simple process. Yes, we are trying to cross over these three modes of material nature. Guna, you know, is rope also. Very strong, we are really bound by it. But then, in this age of Kali, very simple instruction is given to us that just by associating with devotees and chanting the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, we can get out of this condition of bondage. And there is no doubt about it. Very clear, very precise, straight to the point. You know one beauty about Srila Prabhupada's purports? There is no ambiguity. There is no doubt in your mind. When we read, actually I'm doing my master's right now, and luckily I've come to the final course, financial management. You still have a doubt when you're reading, because the thesis is one professor or one school of thought is telling you this. Another school of thought is telling you this. So there is always debate and counter-debate. But when you read Srila Prabhupada's purports, there is nothing about ifs and buts. Am I correct? It is very clear. Very clear, very systematic. And so when we ask ourselves that we are following religion, we're not actually following a religion, we're actually following a science that is so perfect, that clears all doubts. When we read and we are told, okay, this is a thesis, but this thesis is under such presumptions. But when this thesis is placed in the real world, it has no stand. And today, with what has happened with the economy and what is happening with the pandemic and the wars and all that, most of these theses are not holding ground. Because no one envisioned that a small tiny virus that cannot be seen is going to stop the whole economy. So, but when you read Srila Prabhupada's purpose, when you read Bhagavatam, Uttam Shloke, it really dissipates all doubts in our minds. Very clear, very precise. And that's why one of our programs is at least we should read on a daily basis. So, Srila Narad Muni continues to say that in ideal family life, Narad Muni advises Maharaj Yudhishthira that the first duty of a Grihastha is to fully be dependent on Vasudev Lord Krishna. So this is the first instruction, to be dependent, not to be independent, to surrender. The bonum sumum of Bhagavad Gita is to surrender unto the Lord. Sarva dharma parityagya mam ekam saranam varaj. Ham tvam sarva pabeyo mokshami masucha. Just abandon everything and just surrender unto me. Now in the material world, surrender is actually seen as a sign of weakness. Because we don't want to be subordinate. We do not want to be at the mercy of a so-called person. In fact, Srila Prabhupada also says, why do we want to be under the protection of a so-called political or strong leader? They themselves cannot conquer death. How can they give you protection? They themselves cannot conquer over death. How can they give you protection? But our spiritual instruction is to do what? First accept Lord Krishna. Surrender. Why? So you can see in the material world, we are told, don't show your weakness. It is a sign that maybe, you know, your opponent can take advantage of you. I know when the pandemic was really in its heydays, I used to travel to Texas. It's a different country, even if it's in the US. And I used to wear a mask, and I was going in and out of Home Depot and Lowe's, and I had all these cowboys, they were looking at me, and they saw me with a mask. They said, who is this? This guy doesn't have the, he's not a man, he doesn't have the immune system. You know, you're looked upon like as if, what's going on with you? Huh? And I used to tell them, I better be safe than sorry. But this is how you're looked upon, weakness. It's seen as a sign of weakness, just wearing a mask. And here we are being told surrender. And surrender to the Lord. But we know the instructions from Prahlad Maharaj. He's when we surrender to Lord Narsingha, we pray Lord Narsingha daily to protect us. Why? Because when we surrender unto the Lord, we are released from all abay, all anxiety, all fear. And better surrender to the Supreme Lord, because He's the only one who can deliver us. In fact, Lord Shiva instructs Parvati. Lord Shiva says, Mukti Sarvam. Trying to remember the shloka. Is Mukti something that ever sums, there is no doubt about it, that only Lord Vishnu, Lord Krishna can give you liberation. So, in the dealings with family members, Srila Prabhupada writes in his purport, in dealings with your family members and friends, should be performed simply to fulfill their purpose. Yes, you live in a society. Luckily, we live in an association of devotees. But when you're living in within your family atmosphere, yes, we listen to their suggestions. But don't do anything that is gonna make you do or get entangled more in material bondage. But we respect. That's what basically Srila Prabhupada is saying. Respect them just to fulfill the purpose, but do not entangle yourself. Because human life is not meant for this. So it should just be accepted superficially. So Grihastha engaged in activities advised, and what should Grihasthas do? That they should be engaged in activities that are advised by the spiritual master and Shastra. So we are taking guidance from whom? Guru and Shastra. And Srila Prabhupada also in the seventh canto towards this life of ideal life states that actually the process starts with Shravanam. As we know, we have the nine processes, Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu, Smaranam, Pada, Sevanam, Achanam, you know. So the Lord actually, the way we reawaken and the way we actually get engaged is by actually listening to Srimad Bhagavatam and Bhagavad Gita. A Grihastha should spend the money, and then Srila Prabhupada also says that a Grihastha should spend the money in five ways. That whatever we earn, which also is by the blessing of the Supreme Lord, not by our own endeavors, but by the mercy of the Lord. We should be totally like the Pandavas, who were completely reliant on the Supreme Lord. And in fact, whenever there was a situation, like we had a situation with Bhima that he became egoistic. We had Arjun, he had become egoistic that I am the supreme archer. What did Lord Krishna do? He sent Hanuman. He sent Hanuman to crush all their ego. Because for a devotee, ego is a very big problem. Because the Lord wants to check that. But what does the Lord say that, what does Srila Prabhupada say that we should use our Lakshmi towards? He says, first and foremost, worshipping the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And when New Dwarka, we are worshipping the most beautiful Shri Rukmani Dwarka Desh, do you think worshipping the deity costs nothing? So, as a Grihastha, we should worship the Supreme Personality of Godhead. That's one of the five. We should receive Vaishnavas and saintly persons and distribute what? Prasad. So these are exchanges. And then offer prasad to the forefathers and offering prasad to yourself as the last thing. So Srila Prabhupada continues to say that today's Grihasthas are mudadi, ignorant about the goal of life. Do we have any doubt about that from the book distributors? Do they even know what's the goal of life? Do they even know that there is life after death? But just like Archita Prabhu the other day was saying in class, we are so reliant, so dependent on oxygen. But can we say that there is no oxygen? Whether we believe it or not, it is there. So similarly, if someone believes that there is life after death or not, does not actually remove that there is life after death. So, but today's civilization is mudadi, that it's ignorant about the goal of life. And what does Srila Prabhupada say? So it is a dream. Do not live in a dream. It will only last until one leaves this body, dies. So generally we are in a dream, we are in an illusion. Oh, this is my wife, these are my children. I don't even want to go further because Kapila Muni in third canto really hammers when he's explaining to his own mother Devahuti about family life. And those are strong instructions. Really strong instructions. You know, because we are in a devotee class, we are reading Srimad Bhagavatam, we are at a different level that we can maybe accept that. But these are very powerful instructions what Kapila Muni is giving to his own mother in respect to a wife, in respect to your children. How detachment should come. And who is Kapila Muni? Kapila Muni is also an incarnation of the Supreme Lord. And the other day we heard Srila Prabhupada on this, in the Sunday class stating, any incarnation of the Lord is as powerful as the Lord. So do not live in a dream. It will only last until one dies. Forming, and then Srila Prabhupada says, because of this dream that we live in, we form a society of friendship and love. And that is the dream of material life. I belong to so and so, I belong to this, these are my kin and all that. But these are all a dream. We should be at the stage of Brahma Bhuta Prasanna Atma Na Sochati Na Kangshati Sama Sarvesu Bhutesu Mad Bhaktim Labhate Param. That one who is thus transcendentally situated at once realizes the Supreme Brahman and becomes fully joyful. He never laments or desires to have anything else. He is equally disposed to any living entity. In that state, he attains pure devotional service unto me. Brahma Bhuta Prasanna Atma. Now, in Chaitanya Charitamrita, we have one of the most intellectual philosophical discussions that you can actually relish on this planet between Ramananda Raya and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. That chapter where we have a discussion between Ramananda Raya and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, we also understand that staying in one's position must try to inquire about life's goal, Atato Brahma Jigyasa. So yes, we can leave. Srila Prabhupada states, we can leave. In fact, I will say, I will read from Rupa Goswami's instruction to us in Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, that it is not that we cannot stay in a family, but the whole mission should be centered around advancement of spiritual life, bringing Krishna in the center of our life, and not engage in ugra karma, extremely severe endeavor. So we should not be engaged in severe endeavor. And that when we get into this dream, then what happens? It is the cause of bondage in the cycle of life and birth. If one gives up the attachment for the body and increases his attachment for the spirit soul, his life is successful. Now, Lord Kapila in the third canto states that one's satisfaction with one's standard of living is due to deep-rooted attraction for body, wife, children, animals, wealth, and friends. We see around this block how many people have a dog and how attached they are to their dogs. If you're not attached to your children, you're attached to an animal. So Lord Kapila is actually the third canto stating this, that our satisfaction with one standard is so deep-rooted. The family we maintain is created by Maya, Srila Prabhupada writes in his purport. It's actually created by Maya. And it's a perverted reflection of the family in Krishna Loka. So we do have a family. But where is that family? It is through Krishna consciousness, going back home, back to Godhead. It is with Lord Krishna and eternal associates. That is our family. And what we have here is a perverted reflection of that. As long as we are attached to this asat, temporarily, non-existent family, society and family, we are always full of anxieties. Because we are always thinking, hey, if something is going wrong, how am I going to be able to take care of the family? In fact, in Kali Yuga, it's very, very difficult even to take care of your family. And a Grihastha is one who lives. Now, what is a Grihastha? So we have also spoken about Grihamedi. But now, what is a Grihastha? A Grihastha is one who lives with family, wife and children, but whose real purpose of living is to develop Krishna consciousness. So it's not that we cannot progressively move from an ashram. But in doing so, we should understand what is the importance of this ashram. And therefore, one should become a Grihastha and not a Grihamedi. The mistake of modern society or modern civilization is that it does not believe in the next life, like I mentioned. So because they don't know about it, they do not understand this finer subject matter. But like I said, if whether one believes it or not, there is life after death. And in fact, Srila Prabhupada says, as sure as death. So we shouldn't be, as I conclude, we shouldn't be actually attracted to who? We shouldn't be attracted to the beauty of Radha and Krishna. That is the instruction given to us by Srila Prabhupada. So I would like to read a very important statement which is in Bhakti Rasamrit Sindhu by Rupa Goswami. Rupa Goswami says, Anasaktasya visayan yataram upayunjata nirbandha Krishna sambandhe yuktam vairagyam uchyate. Man and woman should live together as householders in relationship with Krishna only. For the purpose of discharging duties in the service of Krishna. Engage the children, engage the wife, and engage the husband all in Krishna consciousness duties. And then all these bodily or material attachments will disappear. Since the vaya medium is Krishna, the consciousness is pure, and there is no possibility of degradation at any time. So this is what we are being told by detachment today. Hare Krishna. Any questions, any comments? Any ifs and buts? Sachitanoi Prabhu.
Arivam, thank you, Prabhu. You were in the beginning of your class, you were describing about attachment and detachment, and then later on you about Grihastha and Grihamedi, the difference. And in your course also you mentioned about some personalities from the Bhagavatam, like the wife of Hiranyakashipu, who at one time was being the demigods were trying to harass her, yes. But then Narada Muni took care of her and preached to her. Then in the other side also you have in another story, in the Sita Ram, when Sita was born, she was taken care by a great sage, pure devotee. So now my question will be, since also you were mentioning before that a man can degrading selves, if you're not in the proper mentality, thinking to watch a woman or preaching to a woman. So sometimes, this is my question or advice, more or less, more than a question is, what advice can you give to brahmacharis or sannyasis who convey the message to the opposite sex? It can be a woman too, trying to preach to a man. But you're not at that higher level that you might think you are. And then, can you mention the risk or the certain rules?
You know, the risk is given to us in itself in Srimad Bhagavatam, that Brahma was allured by his own daughter. We know Lord Shiva. Lord Shiva was captured by the Mohini avatar of Lord Vishnu. So if these great personalities, both Brahma and Shiva are great personalities, can be lured. Imagine Brahma was lured by his own daughter. So this is not something easy for us. We are in this human form of life. You know, there is attraction. And the strongest attraction is Maya. Maya is represented by the woman's body. It's very, very strong. So obviously, we have to be really very careful. And I only look at it as a neophyte, that if Brahma and Lord Shiva were captured, we are in no count. In fact, you know, I know Maharaj may want to say something, or, you know, we have senior devotees here. We have senior devotees here. But basically for me, the check and balance is, even senior demigods like Lord Brahma and Lord Shiva have been captured in this. So, how much vigilant should we be? But then, we should follow Srila Prabhupada. He's an acharya. He's showing us. By example, Srila Prabhupada had Yamuna Devi next to him when he was giving instructions, you know. He used to praise, but he used to look at, in the vision. The vision has changed as a daughter, as a mother. You know, Srila Prabhupada used to speak with so many Mataji, Shilavati Mataji, to instruct her how to do deity worship. But then what was the mood, what was the vision of a saint? You know, he has shown us by his own practical life. So I feel that if we follow Srila Prabhupada, who is our predecessor Acharya, then I am not a brahmachari, so I cannot answer more, but maybe Druta Karma Prabhu, you know, Maharaj is there, but Rudra Prabhu is there, but this is beyond my scope, you know, it's beyond my pay grade to answer this question fully. Maharaj, you have something to say?
Just a brief point in regard to Satchitanoy's question. That temptation is always there. For the biggest, the highest, the greatest, the most learned philosophers, one can always fall if he doesn't do what Krishna says we should do. And what does he say? He says, whatever you do, whatever you eat, whatever you offer, whatever you give away, you do it for me. Think of me. Don't forget me. Always remember me. If you do that, then what happens? I am with you. And if I am with you, my protection will completely shield you. But if you want to be on your own and you feel that I don't need Krishna because I'm so strong, I'm so powerful, women walk away from me, they see I'm so detached, this is bad. We can never be proud when it comes to temptation. The feeling should always be I can fall at any moment. And if you have that, then we will make the necessary adjustments to not fall.
Thank you, Maharaj. I think Swavas Prabhu has something.
Well, you know, this is always an interesting subject matter, and we're always wondering what and how we should deal with it. Well, I think we should understand, first of all, we're all conditioned. Now, there's not one person in this room that can say they're not conditioned by this material energy. So because of that, that's what we have, what we call the Van Ashram system. You have brahmachari, right? You have grihastha, manaprastha. So all these positions are there, how to act in society. A brahmachari is given instruction how he should act. A sannyasi is told how to act. and a vanaprastha and a grihastha. Of the four orders, only the grihastha should be associating with women.
Correct.
The other three orders are not supposed to deal with women. They're not supposed to talk to them, not supposed to be helping them. They should direct them to a grihastha. So, living in this community and wondering what to do and who's attached, not attached, it's very simple. Stay in your lane. Just stay in your lane. If you're a brahmachari, you have no business. Sannyasi, you have no business. Vanaprastha, you're leaving it. Then why should you be associating? Yes, you may think about it, yes, because we're conditioned, but our purification is there when we stay within the ashram. And for a householder, grihastha, there's recommendations. At a certain point, you should take vanapras and should travel, preach, chant more, hear more. Give up worldly activities, working, making money, all those things. Cars, airplanes, boats. Got to give it all up. You just got to chant, travel, preach. So let's stay to the Vanashram system and not think about this and that and everything else. And chant Hare Krishna and we'll be okay.
Thank you. Thank you, Savas Prabhu. Excellent point. Actually, in the purports I was reading on the seventh canto, Srila Prabhupada does very clearly mention that out of the four varnas and ashrams, only one ashram, and that is the Grihastha ashram, is even allowed in regulation, not just even freely, in regulation, in married life to associate with a woman. And the other three ashrams should not. So you're absolutely right. Actually, Srila Prabhupada very clearly states that in his purports. Thank you. Srimad Bhagavatam class ki. Jagat Guru Srila Prabhupada.